Okay, we're going to simplify these exponents. So we have 2n squared. Remember, that's 2n times 2n. So that's going to be 4n squared times negative 4n cubed. Now we do 4 times negative 4 is negative 16. And n squared times n cubed, you have to add the exponents, unless you want to write it all out and count them up. You'll get n to the fifth. So that's negative 16 n to the fifth. Alright, this next one. Now, 10 over 2 is regular canceling. 10 over 2 cancels. You get a 5. But I have an m to the 7th over an m to the 1st. So what's going to happen here is I have the 5 in the numerator. Now we'll deal with the m's. There's more on the top, so you do 7 minus 1 to get m to the 6th. Now look at the next one. You have a c to the 5th. In the bottom, there's more c's in the bottom, so we'll do 5 minus 2 and be left with c cubed in the bottom, and the x to the 8's completely cancel out. So that's our answer. All right. We've got a negative number raised to the 4th, so a negative raised to an even exponent means you're going to have a positive answer, because you'll have four negative signs. So I'm going to have a negative 2 to the 4th, or which is the same as 2 to the 4th, so I have 2 to the 4th, really. And I'm going to have an x cubed to the 4th, and a 3 to the 4th, and an n 4th to the 4th. If you want, you could think of that as a negative 2 to the 4th, okay? We'll get the same answer. So that's 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. We know 4 negatives is going to make a positive 16. We're going to multiply exponents, x to the 12th. 3 to the 4th is 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, which is 81. And n to the 4th to the 4th power, also we're going to multiply exponents. Okay. All right, let's go on to part D. We've got negative 5 to the 3rd power. So we're going to have a negative 5 to the 3rd power. We have an x squared to the 3rd power, a 3 to the 3rd power, and an n to the 3rd power. All right, so this time it's going to be negative when you have three negative signs. So 5 times 5 times 5 is 125. So I'm going to write my answer with a minus sign out in front. 125. Multiply exponents here, x to the 6th. 3 cubed is 3 times 3 times 3. And cubed. And just so it's easier to read this, I'm going to change colors and move it down a little bit. And there you go. All right, let's look at E. Well, here we're dealing with some negative exponents. So we're going to take anything that has a negative exponent and switch it from numerator to denominator, vice versa. Now, you can't do that with the numbers. The 2 and the negative 5 are not exponents. They stay as they are. But this x to the negative 2 comes down as the x to the positive 2, and m to the negative 3 comes down as a positive 3. This x to the 4th is positive, so leave it alone. It's already positive. And the m to the negative 2 goes up. So what I've done is taken the ones that have negatives. I've taken those ones with the negative exponents, and I put them down here to make them positive. You can see it right there by switching. Okay, so we have this minus sign out front then. So we have the 2 and the 5, and now what do? Well, we have an x squared times an x to the 4th, that's an x to the 6th. And I have more m's in the denominator, so if I subtract 3 minus 1, I just have m to the 1st, so I could leave it like that. Now, you could put the negative 2 in the numerator or put the minus sign out in front like I've done here. All right, next one. F. What I could do here is simply multiply, raise everything to the negative 3 power first, or I could fool around with all the negative signs in the inside of the parentheses first. There are a few different ways to do this problem. I'm going to go ahead and just write it as 3 to the negative 3. Now, when I do an x to the negative 4 to the negative 3, we'll multiply exponents, which will give x to the 12th, and m squared to the negative 3 when I multiply exponents will be m to the negative 6. Now again, I could take these ones with the negative exponents, and I know those go in the denominator. So that's going to give you x to the 12th stays up at the top, and I'm going to have 3 cubed over m to the 6th. So the last thing to do is simplify this 3 cubed, so I get x to the 12th over 27 m to the 6th. All right, accurately graph the line passing through 1, negative 2, and have a slope of negative 3. Well, here we are. We know it goes through 1, negative 2, so find that point and just put it down there. There's 1, negative 2. The slope is negative 3, so you have to write that as negative 3 over positive 1. You know the slope's going to be slanting in that direction if it's negative. So in the x direction, I'm going positive 1 and then down 3, and I get another point. Now the other way to write it is a positive 3 over a negative 1. If you do that, you would say I'm going from this point, negative 1 and up 3. But in both cases, I'm going to get slanting the correct direction. And then we just go ahead and draw, hopefully a more accurate line than I have. I can't use a ruler on what I'm using. Okay, so then you want to write it in slope-intercept form. Okay, there's a couple ways to do this. You could use the slope point formula. Y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. Or you could look at the picture and decide what b is. And I could see b is going through 1 here. Notice that tells you b is 1. So one way of getting it is you just look at the picture. You get y equals, you know the slope is negative 3, right? X plus 1. So it looks like that's what the answer should be. And if you plug in this ordered pair, putting in 1 for x and negative 2 for y, it is a true equation. So that does work. But the other way to do it, by instead of visualizing it, is plugging in the numbers. The y1 you're plugging in negative 2, the slope you're plugging in 3, and for x1 you're plugging in 1. And you should get the same answer doing it this way. Negative 3x plus 3, and then subtract 1 from both sides, you get negative 3x plus 1. So we get the right equation either by looking at the picture or by using the slope point formula.